Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. This is Philomena here. If this is your first time, you're absolutely welcome. If you are a regular viewer, you know, I love you. Okay, today I'm going to be going house hunting. I'm going with my friend to look for a new apartment for her. So I'm going to just use this opportunity to show you the different ranges of house and the cost.
They don't want to see us in a Lambo. Are we? Yeah, yeah. Are we? Give a lamba, up on lamba, lamba. Coupé décalé. Yeah. Je m'appelle RWFA. Are we?
The first one we saw was a furnished apartment. That one, they say it's for 6.4 million naira. That one is actually three bedroom flat. It comes with furnished kitchen, furnished chairs in the sitting room, the rooms as well.
Are we? Give a lamba, up on lamba, lamba. Coupé décalé.
Then the next one we saw was a two-bedroom flat. That two-bedroom flat cost 1.3 million naira for 1 year. That one does not have anything in it. In fact, it even needs a lot of work and all those kind of things.
I repeat, all your side of money go take you, girl. Star boy, hey. I like all your pictures on Instagram. Now you're going down in the DM. She looking like Rita Dominic. That's all the wobbly wobbly. When she moaning, she sound like Taylor Swift. She like pornography kind of shit. I'm on the Rocco C. Freddy. She on the Coco Janelli.
The other one I saw was a duplex, four bedroom duplex. It has this very fine everything. I'm going to show everything to you. So that one is for 6.5 million. That one doesn't have any furniture.
No problem. We could put down together and solve them. Baby, I like your concept. I don't need dread down right from the onset. My baby, I for life sample, you're equal. Take it down to the basics. Cook it up, let me taste it. Cook it better than the kite. Cook it better than Rizzi. Cook it better than Falake. Cook it better than Victoria. So delicious. Bend it over, do the dishes. Do the love, black and get delicious. Now she on my body, plenty kisses. I will love you, Gumba. Lamba,
one. I think I saw one other one. It's self-contained for 400,000 naira. And these houses I'm talking about are actually in the city. I'm not going to even call it the main part of the city, because the main part of the city I think is like Maitama, Jabi, all these kind of places, Buse. But this place I'm talking about is actually along the Life Camp Road. So the houses in this city are quite expensive. I won't even lie. The houses around here, you can't even compare it with the one in Ibadan. In fact, so in Ibadan, you can get an apartment of like three bedroom flats for 200,000 naira or even less compared to Abuja. In fact, I think the reason why people say that Abuja is an expensive city is because of the houses. A lot of people, even some places I go to make my hair and get stuff, for regular things that you're supposed to buy for like 1,500 and stuff, you see them selling for 6,500. And you'll be like, ah, but this is the regular price. They'll be like, when I'm paying 1.5 million naira for my shop, I'll not be selling 1,500. No, it's not possible. So I think one of the reasons why they inflate prices is because of the amount they actually pay to rent their shops and their houses and everything. So they factor all that in, even into their items they sell for business people. So the city of Abuja is actually quite expensive when it comes to housing. So these are some of the things that we can use to rate the city of Abuja. So if we're rating, the city is actually high rated, because if you look at the structures as well, the structures are good, the house structures are good. If you check out the quality of things they use in building the house, the quality items are also good. The house, they look durable, you know. So if you factor all that in, you can see that it's not so bad, especially because of the kind of structure that this city has. You know, it's FCT, so I think they have a structure. You must show your plan, you must show all those things. So when you are factoring all those things in, building their houses, I think that is why it should be expensive. But besides that, I don't see any reason why a rented apartment should go for as much as 6.5 million naira. I really don't. I don't know. I should be able to buy my land and build my house with that amount. I'm just saying, because that is actually the truth. Anyways, so for Abuja and Ibadan, we know that the price range for housing is entirely different. However, there is actually some places where you go to and you see cheap houses. I know that places like Apo Resettlement, I think that's what they call it, Apo Resettlement, then Lugbe area, Guagualada area, all those kind of places, you should be able to see a house for about 250,000 and even as cheap as 100,000 naira. So we still have such places, but I'm talking about the main city. To get an apartment, let's say even a one bedroom apartment in the main city, you're not going to spend anything less than 1 million naira for rent. So if you're considering living in Abuja and stuff like that, you should always put a roof over your head into consideration, because you might want to think about it, especially if you're relocating from a city like Ibadan, Lagos, or places like that. It even appears that houses are expensive in Lagos, but I must say that I think houses are more expensive in Abuja because of what I've seen so far. So that is about it. If you liked this video, I would like you to give it a thumbs up. If you're yet to subscribe, please click on the subscription button. It is free of charge, totally free. You're not being charged for subscribing. Then, what else? I'm going to see you on my next one. Until next time, guys. Bye.